What's going on, everybody? I'll let some people get on here. I didn't start my preview screen as early as I normally do, so we'll let some people come on. Who's on here? Say hi in the comments. Hit the like here. Let's see who's who's hanging out right now. And then we'll get started. I got something I think is hilarious. It has nothing to do with anything we're doing here today. But I personally think it's really funny. So in the state of this country right now, I think that we need to add some humor in there. So I'm doing it. So hopefully you guys enjoy. Who's all here? Let's see some likes. Here we go. What's up, Jeremiah? All right, so not a lot of people on yet, but we'll get there. All right, so this is episode 9 of Pew Pew Nation Live. I missed last week, and I apologize, guys. I had some surgery on my mouth that is still messed up, and I was not talking. So it was bad. I finally ate some real food today, like for the first time. It's literally been exactly a week, so, and it still hurts like hell. So I don't know. I don't know what's going on, but we'll figure it out. So let me find my thing here. There it is. All right. So here we go. Enjoy, guys.
His old life behind.
That's illegal.
You're gonna end up in jail for fraud.
I take pictures of the sky.
You have forgotten who you are, and so forgotten me.
I'm never gonna financially recover from this.
Remember who you are. You are the one true king.
And you're gonna have to kill me to shut me up. And I'm gonna liberate the animal world.
It's a legendary tale filled with excitement, plus dozens of wonderful new characters.
Oh my God, that guy has a mullet.
All right, the sound didn't work. We got to start it over. You guys got to watch it with sound. It's just amazing. Somebody's a genius. Here we go.
Walt Disney Pictures presents its all-new full-length motion picture.
Fuck yeah!
He was born to rule.
This'll all be mine?
Everything the light touches.
Wow.
But a shadow lies over the kingdom.
I will be king!
And then I'm gonna put a bullet right between your f***ing eyes.
He grew up hoping to leave his old life behind.
That's illegal.
You're going to end up in jail for fraud.
I take pictures of the sky.
You have forgotten who you are, and so forgotten me.
I'm never going to financially recover from this.
Remember who you are. You are the one true king.
And you're going to have to kill me to shut me up. And I'm going to liberate the animal world.
It's a legendary tale filled with excitement, plus dozens of wonderful new characters.
Oh my God, that guy has a mullet. Are you getting this? Ow, son of a bitch.
Walt Disney Pictures presents an entertainment event you'll never forget.
He's like, I am the Tiger King.
I don't know. I had to play it. I just thought it was hilarious. Everybody's obsessed with Tiger King right now. So, why not? I thought it was pretty funny. Add a little humor into the crazy world that we're in right now. So, hopefully you guys liked that one. But, anyway, we'll get into some firearm stuff. Who do we got watching here, guys? My thing is showing a whole bunch of people, not a ton of comments yet. So comment if you're watching. Say hi or something. And tell me I'm ugly or something. Delay seems to be extremely long today, so that's cool. But if you missed it, we just played the Lion King, Tiger King intro. So, there we go. What's up, Joe? Looks like Frank's in here. Hey, Frank. A couple people, Carol. So we'll get started, guys. So yesterday, I'm sure most of you saw that I went down to the Capitol down to Lansing yesterday to join the protest down there, the gridlock protest against Governor Whitmer here in Michigan. Obviously, there's people on here from all over the country, but if you've watched the news, Michigan has been the center of the attention pretty much on how just how bad it is. This early last week or this week, no, last week, late last week, Governor Whitmer shut down the whole state further, and now you're not allowed to buy non-essential items, is what she calls it. So you're not allowed to buy garden hoses, plants, mulch, non-essential businesses that are that she deemed non-essential, like lawn services, painters, roofers, all this stuff that's non-essential, plumbing. It has to be an emergency in order to do this stuff. Like, I had to have surgery on my mouth last week. To do it, I had to sign an affidavit saying that I was in pain, and then the doctor, the dentist, had to sign off that what exactly he did to my mouth and how bad it was, and that there was an infection that could have spread and gotten even worse. So, it's an absolute joke, is what it is. It's stomping all over our constitutional rights, is what it's doing, and pretty much Michiganders got sick of it. So, they put together a rally yesterday to chainsaw blades. A rally yesterday to show the governor and show our government pretty much that we're not going to take much more of this stuff. Like, we're done with it. So, what's going on, EJ? The turnout was absolutely epic. It was amazing. It was one of the most incredible things I've ever been part of in my life, honestly. To see that many people show up, they're saying tens of thousands. I'm saying probably upwards of 50,000 people once I left, because I had to leave a little early. They had the entire freeway, not police, the cars, the protest had the entire freeway pretty much shut down, pretty much gridlocked. All of Lansing in Michigan to completely gridlocked, just shut everything down. It was unbelievable. No problems, no issues at all. There was no fights, no littering, you know, nobody got hurt. I don't care what anybody says. There was not one ambulance or emergency vehicle that couldn't get through. The hospital entrance was wide open, made sure that they kept it open. There was about 200 people or so that were out of their vehicles. This was an in-vehicle protest. There was about 200 down there or so throughout the day that were out of their vehicles. And of course, that's what the media, you know, tried to report mainly on, including our governor. So she acknowledged the protest and then instantly said that we put all these people's lives in danger because we were all out of our cars. It wasn't true. The about 60 to 70% of the people that were out of their cars were me, like me, media, taking pictures, videos, all the reports that you guys saw on TV. Joe McAllister just said he saw me on Tucker Carlson yesterday, which is pretty cool. Everybody's been messaging me that they saw me all over the place. I literally haven't seen one of these videos yet, guys. So if you find one or if you DVR'd it or something, send it to me. Because I haven't even seen myself on TV. I didn't do any interviews or anything like that. But it was I was just, like I said, the chances of me being on were really great because there wasn't a lot of people there. And the people that were there mainly were media that were parked in place that, you know, they found a spot and that's where they stayed and they did interviews and stuff like that. But it wasn't what they made it out to be. Like, there was 7,000 people on the state capitol grounds. There was nobody there. There was hardly anybody out of their vehicles. It was about 75 to 100 people total throughout the day. Michigan State Police actually confirmed those numbers as well. They said that no more than 200 people showed up outside of their vehicles on the state capitol grounds the entire day. That was through the whole thing. So this thing was scheduled from 12 to 2. I got down there about 10:30, and I did some live videos on I started another Facebook page that's Governor Whitmer is bad for Michigan. And I did some live videos on that and some on my personal page. And you guys can see how many people were down there. I mean, it was like gridlocked 8 to 10 blocks back at 11:30 in the afternoon. And it started at 12. I left at about 1 o'clock. I had to get home. And it was still gridlocked. And they had the whole freeway shut down. Everything was shut down. It was amazing. It was absolutely incredible to watch the whole thing unfold and just be part of it. It was just a super powerful, super empowering thing to see. I mean, it was crazy. It really was. Like, I couldn't even describe it. I didn't know what to expect going down there, and it was worth going down there for me anyway. It was really refreshing to see. So, yeah, EJ said he saw it on TV. Joe saw me on Tucker Carlson. Norm said it's on World News. Had a few Brits texting him. So I guess I was over across the sea, too. What's up, Neil? Yeah, 11:30 a.m. It was absolutely packed out already. I mean, 11 o'clock it was packed out. Like I said, I drove by the Capitol. I did like a loop just to see what was going on. And I drove by. It was like 11 o'clock. And it filled up that quick. It was crazy. I mean, everybody down there, American flags. There was tons of hilarious signs. No, like I said, no issues. We had no problems at all down there. Michigan State Police were super cool. Lansing Police were super cool. I talked to a lot of different officers, asked them what their opinions were on all this and how they felt about the whole thing. And every single one of them said that they supported us, that they were there, that they thought we were doing the right thing, that they think the governor's doing the wrong thing. It was pretty cool. So, what's up, Joe? Neil said Confederate flags. There was like one or two Confederate flags. I don't know why everybody's making a big deal out of that. It's a flag. It's not that big of a deal. Maureen said Michigan State Police weren't wearing masks. They were not wearing masks, and that was a big deal because if you follow me on Facebook, you saw that yesterday I ended up having to make a post about it. I finally was done. I'm not arguing with people anymore. I'm done with it. My whole problem with this thing, guys, and I've said it before, and I never have changed my view on this. I never will. My issues with this whole thing are the fact that the government is telling us what to do. They're telling us how we have to do things, when we have to do them, when we can do them, and I'm sick of it, and I'm not going to do it. So, like, everybody yesterday sitting there telling me that, oh, my God, you were down there without a mask. Yeah? So what? I was outside without a mask. Guess what? I went to the grocery store today without a mask. I went to the pet store today to get cat and dog food without a mask. I don't want to wear a mask. I refuse to wear a mask. Also, with a mask, half you people that wear them aren't wearing them properly. So if you wear it off of your nose or down around your chin, or I had guys at the grocery store, they had them up on their heads today, that's not doing anything for you. And if you do wear it properly and you're not used to wearing a mask, try to count how many times you touch your face. You end up touching your face more and spreading more germs to your face by wearing the mask than you do if you don't wear the mask. So less of you wear one every day. Also, the only mask that's going to do anything for you really is the N95 masks. So these people that are walking around with cloth on their face, you're just walking around with a t-shirt on your face. That's all it is. It's no different. Put a turtleneck on. Neil said it's going to be mandatory. Yeah, I don't really follow those rules, obviously. I was at a protest with 50,000 people yesterday, and we weren't supposed to be there either. So, missed some other comments here. Hey, Ryan, what's going on? Justin's on here. Josh, Macbeth, what's going on, brother? Yeah, Maureen said our doctor friends aren't even wearing masks. So that was actually, that's a good point. Last night, I was really getting pissed off. I was just deleting comments. I don't care. I don't need to argue with somebody. I've never told one person in my whole life on Facebook what they need to do. Never once. This is what you need to do in order to protect yourself or to protect others. I've never said it. I refuse to get into boasting and bravado on Facebook and talk about what I would do in a shooting or something like that. You'll never see me do that. The other thing you'll never see me do is call people names. I don't call people names on Facebook. I might say it off the screen, but I'm not going to type it. It's one thing that I always have stuck to and that I won't change. I don't tell people what to do. There's no reason to. Everybody can make their own decisions. I'm so sick and tired of being told that I need to wear a mask in order to save lives. If you're worried about me not wearing a mask or somebody not wearing a mask out in public, don't go out in public right now. It's as simple as that. And if you do go out, wear your mask and gloves if that's what you want to do. I don't care, but I don't need to conform to what you want me to do. It's just like the schools being shut down. There's no reason that I didn't have the choice to send my child to school. Teachers could have had the choice if they wanted to make the teachers have the choice to come in. I guarantee more than half the teachers would have came in and showed up to school. If you didn't want to send your kid, don't send your kid. But why do you get to make, why can't I make that choice but you get to do it? It doesn't make sense. But yeah, I had, I kind of got off subject there. I had a doctor, a friend of mine that I went to high school with. She married a doctor, and he was chiming in, and she was chiming in on Messenger yesterday. They wanted to stay anonymous, but he works in a hospital that treats COVID-19. That's what he does all day long. And he doesn't wear a mask outside of the hospital. He doesn't need to. He said it does nothing for you. And he also said that all the numbers are lies. Everything that we're seeing right now is not the truth. Like, yes, this virus is bad. This virus is deadly. It's killed people. But try to find numbers on how many people have had heart attacks in the last 2 weeks. Try to find numbers on how many people died in car accidents. Try to find numbers in Detroit. The numbers are super high on COVID-19. How many people got shot in Detroit in the last week? Can't find the numbers. It's literally impossible to find them because what's happening is the hospitals are claiming every single death as COVID-19 because no matter what, if that guy came in, if that gangbanger came in, got shot in the head, and that's why he died, the hospital ain't going to get paid on that because that guy didn't have insurance. They're not getting paid to handle that body. If they claim it as COVID-19, they get full funds from the government to handle that body. So why would they not be claiming these as COVID-19 cases? So the numbers are inflated and the facts are not there. They're not reporting the entire thing. You see, like yesterday there was a nurse that was up on a walkway, like a bridge that goes over the road, and they were videoing. There's one nurse that doesn't like people out or whatever. Oh, they're blocking the ambulance paths. So 1,000 people saw this video, shared it, and that weren't down there, and were like, oh, they're blocking the ambulance paths. In her video, you can clearly see the paths open. There's so much misinformation, it's insane. There's another one that was out that was an ambulance stuck in traffic, like under an overpass bridge. It was bullshit. It wasn't yesterday. I don't know where the picture was even taken. You couldn't see a license plate in the picture. It wasn't yesterday, though, I guarantee it, because every single car down there had signs, writing, flags, whatever on it. There's not one flag, not one sign, not any writing, nothing on any of these cars down there. It wasn't yesterday. It didn't happen. Michigan State Police and Lansing Police reported that there was nothing held up, nothing, no emergency services that were canceled that had issues, nothing. So this is, it's all lies. That's the thing, is you don't know what to believe. And I refuse to buy into it is my thing. So you can call me stubborn, you can call me an asshole, you can call me whatever you want. I don't care. I get called it every day. But the facts are the facts. So I just don't know. I don't know. I have a problem with being told what I have to do when other people get to choose to do what they want to do. So makes no sense. Let's read some comments here. Neil Reynolds said, I saw a dude at Meijer with a straight-up military canister gas mask. I've seen some pretty awesome stuff. I wish I would have thought to take pictures of some of these people. I had this woman in Meijer a couple weeks ago, actually. She was wearing a snorkel mask, like the full goggles with the snorkel in her mouth with like a piece of like cheesecloth like duct taped around the top of it to breathe out of, as like that was going to do something for anything. And then she had like the Mr. Clean, like you're cleaning your kitchen, you know, those big thick rubber gloves. She had those duct taped around her wrists. it was amazing. And then just so many people that are wearing this stuff wrong. Like if you're going to wear a mask, it needs to cover your nose and your mouth. Like if you have it like this and you look like your mouth's covered but your nose isn't covered, it's not doing anything. If it's around your chin, it's not doing anything. In your hand, it doesn't do much for you. Also, if you're somebody that wants to wear a mask, great. And if you want to wear gloves, awesome. How about this? Take your gloves off and put them in a bag and throw them away when you get home. Or find a trash can to throw them away in. Meijer parking lot this morning when I was there was literally riddled with rubber gloves. Like, do something with them. Why do we have to throw them all over the ground? It's crazy. Joseph, yeah, thanks, man. Jeremiah said, made it 42 years without one. I'll take my chances. Exactly. I'm 35 years old, maybe 36. I don't remember. And exactly, I've never worn a mask except for when I'm doing some sort of carpentry or something that I need a mask for, legitimately, construction stuff. But I don't need a mask. I've been out this whole time with all this stuff going on without a mask. I know nurses that the only reason they wear a mask is out in public is because they're around this stuff all the time, and it's to protect other people because they're exposed to it, which I fully understand, no problem at all. Like I said, I don't have a problem if you just are paranoid and you're just afraid to do anything without a mask on. I don't care. That's your right and that's your possibility. You're allowed to do that. That is totally 100% okay. Just as if it is 100% fine that I'm not wearing a mask. Just stop telling people what to do. That's all. That is literally the only issue I have with any of this stuff. I don't care otherwise. Do what you want to do. Do what you have to do. Today I had a guy on Facebook that was arguing with me, that was telling me that the problem with me going out there yesterday and doing my job is to take pictures. I am in the media, unfortunately. I'm in the outdoor industry media, but that is my job. So I went down there to take pictures yesterday, and my whole goal was honestly to debunk all of the stuff that the media was going to lie about. And that's exactly what I did. And that's why everybody's so pissed off, is because they saw these news reports. Oh, this is what happened. And then they saw my report where I was actually in the mix. And you guys can see that because I was literally all over TV. And my reports weren't the same as theirs, as the ones they wanted to believe that they've been believing. So That's why I think people had such an issue with what I did yesterday. And there was a lot of people that had no issues with it that absolutely loved it. So, read some more comments here. Hold on. I don't want to get behind. Neil Reynolds. Wait, where was I at? Maureen said, I'm not going to live in fear anymore. There's no reason to, exactly. Neil said, the media never tells you how many people have recovered and been discharged from COVID-19. Only deaths and cases. Exactly, Neil. And that's the thing, is nobody is telling you that. You're not hearing those numbers. My brother actually told me today that he found a report that broke it down by city, or, city, township. It went really low. So he said that he lives in Milford. He said that there's 3 confirmed cases in Milford, according to this thing. I don't know what it was. He hasn't sent it to me yet. I want to see it, but the facts are the facts. Like, if you look at the real numbers, even the numbers they're inflating are still not even as bad as the regular flu every year. So we it's a bad virus. It kills people just like other viruses do. There's just no reason to panic and do what we're doing right now. I mean, I went to Home Depot today. I had to get a couple things for around the house. And, like, literally they have, like, the tiling section cut out, like the flooring that's blocked off. Lawn and garden stuff is mainly blocked off. I need a new grill. I was going to look at grills. Can't get down the aisle. It's completely shut off. Those non-essential items. You know, cooking is non-essential, apparently. The other day I went to Ace Hardware and I needed a chainsaw blade. So I needed to cut some stuff down on the side of my house. Needed a chainsaw blade. No big deal. So go in there. They got them like behind, and they're not locked up, but they got like a magnetic lock on the hook so people can't take them off without somebody unlocking the magnetic lock. So I find an employee and I'm like, hey, I need a chainsaw blade. This is the one I need. It's like, oh, if it's locked, we're not allowed to sell it. Manager said we can't take that stuff off because we'd get too close to customers and it's non-essential items. So I looked at him and I said, so the tree that's laying on my house is not essential for me to get off my house because all the tree companies are shut down and I have a tree on my house. I need to cut it down. I didn't have a tree on my house. Just what I came up with real quick because it's the facts are the facts. If there was a tree laying on my house, I don't have a tree company to call to come get it off because it's a non-essential business and you can't call them right now. They're all closed. Luckily, I have a neighbor that's a tree guy, so I'd be able to do it. But it's the same thing with like landscape companies. Like that's my wonder is how many people are dying because of the governor's bullshit unconstitutional lockdown here than would be dying from COVID-19 if we didn't do this. What about all the elderly that, you know, that need somebody to take care of their lawn for them? And, you know, if they're like my dad does his own lawn still, but if you're like my dad, when he's 85 years old, he's going to be, if he doesn't have somebody doing his lawn, he'll be out there doing his lawn, worrying about having a damn heart attack. So how many people have died because they've had to do this labor that normally they hire somebody to do, one of these non-essential workers? How many people have died from suicide because they have some sort of mental illness and they've been stuck in their house for the last 2 months now almost and nothing to do, nobody to talk to, nowhere to go, and no social interaction, and they have issues because of that and they end up killing themselves or hurting themselves because of it? How many routine checkups and surgeries can't be done that are going to turn into emergencies or possibly, like my mouth, an infection that could have killed me if the infection spread before I caught it? How many of those don't get caught because of routine stuff that can't be done now? People can't do routine checkups. You know, all these different scenarios. There's a million different things that we could talk about. How many of these things don't get done and how many people die because of the lockdown than would die if we didn't lock the state down from COVID-19? That's what I want to know. But the numbers aren't there. There's no way to ever tell that. Domestic violences are way up. I just read a report. I mean, like, insane amounts of domestic violences. People get sick of living with each other. You're like, sometimes you need a break. You need to get out of the house. It's just ridiculous. Let's read some comments here, guys. If you have comments on this topic or questions or anything that happened down in Lansing, like I said, I didn't want to talk too much about Lansing directly because this is this goes across the whole nation here, but it goes for everywhere right now. It's like 48 states that are in some sort of lockdown. Plus, the government has done a stay-at-home order, but they haven't ordered anything actually closed or anything like that. So, Maureen said, "Don't fall on the media bullshit. Use brains. We aren't sheep." Exactly. Joseph Snell, "I'd like to know where all the hospital gowns and masks and gloves go when they're done." Yeah, that's a good question. Who knows? Speaking of hospitals, too, it's funny that, you know, everybody, that the government, the governor reports that across the whole country report that all the hospitals are overrun. Oh, my God, they can't keep up. We're out of ventilators, all this stuff. Built all these, you know, military makeshift hospitals in Detroit and stuff like that. They haven't seen a patient yet. Like Beaumont Hospital, giant hospital in Detroit, Detroit area. It was running last week at 60% in their ICU, and they had over 300 ventilators available. The doctor I talked to yesterday flat out told me that they've hardly seen any new cases, and any deaths that are actual COVID-19 deaths have been from people that are on ventilators for the last like 3 weeks. There's antibodies out there now. Our bodies start to become immune to things. So this virus is not even as bad as it was when it first got over here. And it's just ridiculous because they're not reporting any of that stuff. Norman said, "Blowing red paint out of, wait, what? Oh, the days of blowing red paint out of noise after car painting. After, out of nose, probably, after car painting without a mask. I get you. I worked in a body shop before, too, so I get you." Norman said, "I've never been so proud of Michigan." I've never been so proud to be a Michigander, to be an American. Seriously, like, it was the coolest thing I've ever seen, guys. I'm 35 years old, and I've never seen anything like that in my life. Like, I've gone to protests. I went to Trump rallies. I went to, I think it was McCain. I don't remember who was running. I went with my mom to a McCain rally or one of those candidates. And, you know, those were cool. Those were powerful. Lots of people there. The Trump rally was huge. It was, you know, intense, lots of energy. Seeing that many people out there blocking the road, honking their horns, all just kind of celebrating being American. It was empowering. It was cool. It was really, really cool. I'm really glad I actually, actually went out there and checked it out. Josh Macbeth said, "I need a dart partner." Marco Polo. Josh, maybe I need to take a trip up there since it's illegal. It's not my second home, right? So I can go. That's cool. I can do that. Jeremiah, you were down there as well. "Great experiences. Proud to be part of this movement." Yeah, it was cool. Neil said, "Where do the ventilators our automakers are making go?" Probably in some giant storage facility somewhere with the Ark and the Holy Grail, just in case for another day. That'll be like Indiana Jones 5 when Harrison Ford is like on his deathbed and has to find his own ventilator. He'll find that warehouse. Neil Reynolds said, "Nothing blocked off out by me." So it depends on the store, and really it depends on the manager. They can't, the government can't enforce it at all. So like Home Depot's by me anyway have caved and they block stuff off. Walmart did it a long time where they had like limited it to 25 people in the store. It was stupid. The Meijer by me, I live in Highland, Michigan. White Lake is right next door, and the Meijer that I go to that I grocery shop at, I know the manager because I used to deliver goods in there. And I talked to him, and he pretty much said, "Yeah, no, screw them. I'm not blocking anything off. If you're here to buy groceries, go to the other side of the store and buy a movie. I don't give a shit. It doesn't matter to him. So he's got everything open. So I was there today again, still nothing closed. So it was pretty cool that he's doing that. Hey, Tina. This is how you got on. Is Marcy watching? My niece loves watching me on here. So she always wins stuff. So you guys got to compete with her today if she's watching. Neil said Marco. No, it's Polo. Norm, Waterford 2, made lawn care essential. Thank you, James. James said, very well said, sir. Much respect. Thank you, sir. I think James was down there yesterday, too, actually. I didn't get to run into some of these guys, but Neil said it took 3 different attempts, and my niece tried to drug herself to death to get her in a mental facility. Thankfully, she's getting treatment, is doing much better. Well, thank God she's doing better, man. But it's sad that it takes that much. You know what I mean? Like, if she needed the help without all this crap going on, she would have been able to go get the help. But it's just ridiculous. Like, it just, you wonder how many more people are dying, like I said before, because of all this crap, and where they could just go get the help they needed, or hire the service that they needed, or do whatever they needed to do. Not to mention the financial strain, everybody. Like, finances cause probably half the suicides in the country. So, you know, I live it every day. I mean, I'm a writer in the outdoor industry and a photographer. It's not like I'm rich. Magazine stopped selling, I'm screwed. So, you know, nobody's making money. A magazine's not something that they're buying. So make sure you guys go buy magazines. Keep me employed. Neil and Maureen are having a conversation. We call Maureen Moe. Or Mo. Hey, Alicia, what's going on? Joe McAllister said, where's Jeff? He's probably hiding in a corner somewhere with his mask on. Macbeth said, bring it. I think I might, man. Maybe next week I'll swing up there for a couple days. It's not that long of a trip. Especially no traffic. It's awesome, man. Like, so I saw probably 8 state troopers on my way out to Lansing. I'm about 45 minutes, 50 minutes away from Lansing. And not one of them was pulling anybody over. They don't care. The state troopers I talked to down at the rally, at the protest, all said the same exact thing. They're like, we're not writing tickets. We don't care. We support you guys being out here. The Michigan Liberty Militia was out there. A bunch of people had problems with that too, because why would you open carry, or, you know, why were the guns necessary? And what people don't understand is this protest wasn't about seeds and gardening and stuff like that. This was about our constitutional rights. So if you're going to shit on our constitutional right to be able to just go out of our house, what else are you going to take from us? That's the whole point of this thing. That is why the Michigan Liberty Militia and a couple of the Proud Boys were down there and stuff like that. That's what these guys are down there for, because they're showing that you're not going to do it. We're not going to stand for it. So it was pretty cool. Brendan Bendini, what's going on, man? Neil Reynolds said, I could always shoot porn. That won't go away. Red Lettuce, how's it going? Affordable Health Care Act wrecked the health care system. Yes. Yes, it did. That's when I stopped having health insurance. Hey, Alicia, how's it going? Dennis, I saw you were watching. Don't be creeping. Say hi. Dennis has been scared of COVID-19, I think, because he hasn't been here. He's my spot's empty over here. It's waiting for you. So, but you guys have any questions about any of that stuff? What I saw yesterday, any of that kind of stuff? Do we got people? Who's on here still? Is there anybody on here? Let's get some. some comments, some likes. See what you guys think here. Mark Scooby, what's your thought on people not going to their second homes?
I mean,
do you want my real thought on it? Or do you want the PC version? No, I'm not PC. My thought is I think it's bullshit. That's my thought right there. My buddy Scott, I don't know if he's watching right now, but he's got a cabin up north in Gaylord, Michigan. And I go up there quite often and help him out around there, hang out, you know, drink some beers and stuff. And technically, he's up there when they sign this order. So technically, he can't come home legally to his house in White Lake because of this bullshit order. Another guy that works, my buddy Dan, works with Athlon Outdoors with us, and he has a summer home up in Charlevoix, and he's pretty much said, fuck it, I'm going up there, because he doesn't care. So, and that's where I'm at, too. I mean, if I had property up there or whatever, I'm talking to Josh McBeth on here right now. He needs a dart partner, and I'm kind of worried about his mental health. So I think he might need me to come up there and play darts and drink beer with him for a couple days next week. So it's a. I feel like that makes it essential, right? Saving somebody's life. We're still playing Marco Polo. Red Lettuce said, just drop by. Got to go take care of the dogs. The governor doesn't have the right to restrict our movement or right to assemble. Later, stay safe and sane. See you, Red Lettuce. Go take care of your probably 300 dogs you have now. Thanks for stopping by. Joe McAllister, want to go to the UP, but heard they are turning people around at the bridge. It might be. I don't know. I mean, how do you prove that you live up there or whatever? I don't know. It's so stupid. But the state parks are all open. So you go to the state parks and walk around and whatever else. I don't know. Is this like a thing now on my comments? Is Marco Polo? I think we feel like we need to change the name. Something gun related. Like, let's do Smith, Wesson, something like that. Who's here, guys? Who's still here? We got a bunch of giveaways today, a couple things. I got the Kimber Black Ice Rapide to show you guys. Yeah, look at that thing. Like, that thing is, it's a sexy gun. That's all I got to say. It is a sexy, sexy beast of a gun. Who's here? Give me some likes. Give me some comments. Is Tina still watching? Marcy, are you on here? Marcy will like this gun. I'm just going to give you a preview of it. Oh, man. Look at that thing. Look at that thing. See, it's clear. Oh, yeah. We'll get there, Joe. We'll get there, Joe. I got a whole list I'm going to go over. So I don't have a video of this one yet. I'm hoping to do the video tomorrow, actually, is my goal. Let's see. Safety first, guys. Magazine is empty. Gun is empty. See, right through it there. Always make sure that your gun is clear before you start screwing around with it and playing with it like I am. So this is the Kimber Black Ice Rapide. I'm going to go do a range video. I've not shot this yet, but I'm going to go do a range video tomorrow, hopefully. It was literally snowing today in Michigan. It was 60 degrees last week. It was snowing today in Michigan and yesterday out at the protest. Maureen and Neil are going to fight for the Kimber. Actually, guys, it's mine. So I'm going to go do a range video tomorrow. You can check out my bench review of this thing that I did. It's on my YouTube channel, Pew Pew Nation. Real easy to remember, guys. Check that thing out. Leave me a like and a comment. Tell me what you think of the video. I'm going to start doing those bench videos, bench reviews for everything I get in. And then I'm also going to be doing a shooting video. The shooting video for this one is actually going to be through Athlon Outdoors. So it won't go on my YouTube channel, but I will make sure that I share a link to it. So this is the Kimber Black Ice Rapide. Let me just show you guys this. Oh, my God. And seriously, like, I am a 1911 junkie. I love 1911s. This is one of the sexiest 1911s that I've ever had. I've ever had in my hands. I've had STIs in here. I've had Nighthawk Customs in here. Wilson Combat 1911s. I've had everything you could possibly imagine in my room right here in my hands. This is one of the sexiest guns that I've ever had in my possession. I just hope it shoots good. I've had issues with Kimbers in the past with their finish being junk, things like that. This thing doesn't seem to have those issues. I haven't said, like I said, I haven't shot it yet, but I could tell it was going to have those issues on the other ones that I had. So this thing comes in 9 mil, 10 mil, and 45. This is the 9 mil version. I asked Kimber to send me the 10 mil. They sent me a 9 mil. It's all right. I'm okay with it. I just really wanted a 10 mil 1911, so I was going to make sure that it was mine after the review. Unfortunately, they sent me a 9 mil, which I'm okay with, though. It's a single stack 9 mil. I think it holds 9 rounds in the magazine. Pretty standard-looking 1911 magazine. The only thing they changed is this little thing on the bottom, this little plate. When it's in the gun, it looks good. It gives it a little better aesthetics, I guess. But it does grab my pinky, I've noticed. So, and I haven't even shot it yet. So that might be a little bit of an issue, changing your grip a little bit so that thing doesn't grab onto your finger. And I have smaller hands, so it shouldn't really be touching my finger, and it does, unfortunately. Like I said, this one's a 9 mil. Let's see some of the specs here. It's 38 ounces unloaded. So it's actually pretty light for a 1911. They put these windows in the top and the sides of the slide, save some weight there. So it's very balanced. It feels really good. Like I loaded up a magazine yesterday and put this thing in there, and it was just very, very well balanced gun. It felt great and points really well, points really naturally. It does have these True Glow TFX Pro day and night sights. At first I thought they were fiber optic because they have cuts on the tops. So normally it's a fiber optic sight, has a little cut there. They're actually tritium, but they give you a little bit more glow during the day because of that cut. It grabs light kind of like fiber optics. And then at night, I don't even know. You might be able to see it there. You can kind of see it. They glow. You can't really see it in this video, but they do glow. They look good. I don't like how tall they are. I'm not a big fan of the True Glows because they're just so bulky. Like, you can see they stick way off the top of this gun. Not a huge fan of that, but they do point really, really well. I mean, it's just a super natural, easy point. Kimber thought of everything through this. They really went like all out, all the way down this gun, where they have the lightning cuts, so like a double cut lightning cut. And they don't look super aggressive, but they really do grip well. So you can really press check this thing super easily, which is something I like because a lot of times, especially with 1911s, they don't have any cuts on the front. And you can't press check that at all. This thing, I can easily just press check it and grabs on. The grip on this thing, grip panels are G10 grip panels, and everything on here matches the gun. I mean, the dimpling on here matches the front strap dimpling. The back of the gun, the back strap here matches the cuts in the front, as well as these cuts match the serrations, and then these cuts here, these little indents, match the cuts in the front. Everything on this matches. It's just nice. That's the slide release. Slide release is good. God. The one thing that I have to say on this gun, and I hope you guys can hear it, check out this trigger. So that's the break. Reset this thing. Ready? That's it. That's it. That was it. Oh, God. I just want to lick it. It's mine. I love this gun. It's just sexy. It's just a nice gun. Kimber did a really good job with this thing. Hopefully it shoots as well as it looks and feels. Like I said, it's got the, you know, basic controls of a 1911. Teardown's the same. It's got the barrel bushing. So it's kind of a pain to tear down like any other 1911. Does have the thumb safety, ambidextrous. It's a nice gun though. That trigger. You guys got to hear that again. Hopefully you can hear this. That's the trigger. Reset that thing. Ready? That's it. That's it. 4.5 pound, 5 pound trigger. And it's just gorgeous. Usually on a 1911, I like the flat triggers. This thing is so nice. The pull is so nice. This thing's sexy. That's all I can say. That's all I can say to describe it. It's just awesome. Maureen said, I'm sure it'll be fine for me because it's mine. So your grip doesn't matter. I'm not going to let you shoot it. Alicia says she's at her neighbor's watching. Now everyone's talking about guns. Good. I did my job. Pew Pew Nation Live did its job and got everybody talking about guns. That's what we like. Oh. Oh, man. Are you guys ready for giveaways? Because I think I want to give stuff away today. Just like, oh, I love it. It's so nice. Oh, MSRP. Good idea. So the 9mm version, I don't understand it. It's more money than the 10mm and the 45. 9mm is like $1,500. The 45 is like $1,420 or something like that. And the 10mm is $1,420. I don't know why the 9mm is more money. That makes no sense to me. And the other thing, guys, that I thought of now that I should have mentioned, it comes with one magazine. Come on, Kimber. One magazine? I got a Springfield EMP that I showed you guys a couple weeks ago in my safe that came with four magazines for the same price. One? Pretty disappointed in that. And that's just a Kimber thing. They do that. One magazine. Like, why? Doesn't make any sense. But for $1,500, I expect at least two magazines. Come on. But with that being said, I'll spend like $20 on a magazine so that I can fondle this gun. It is just an awesome gun. Oh, McKinstry's on. What's up, buddy? Give the gun away, Mark Scooby said. Yeah, right. We can auction it. Maybe we'll auction it off. First one to hit $3,000 gets it from me. Give you a deal. Mike McKinstry said, I'll trade you a high five for that gun.
High five.
Nope. Matthew Fisher. What's up, buddy? Matthew Fisher just joined us. It's all right, man. You missed, it'll be on YouTube later, so you can watch my rant on the government. You should like that. EJ said this one is sweet. Vin just joined us. What's up, buddy? Alicia, Nick just got a 380 micro. Have you reviewed it yet? I love it for daily carry. The micro carry from Kimber, is that the one you're talking about? I've shot them. I've not done a review on one, though. That was actually one of the guns I had issues with the finish on. So make sure you watch the finish on that thing and keep it dry. Not dry from lubrication, but dry from water and moisture. So when you carry it, try to pull it out of the holster every once in a while. Just check it. Or if it starts having issues, just get it Cerakoted and it'll take care of the problems. No big deal. It is a nice gun, though. I've shot them before. Neil Reynolds said sold. $3,000? Sweet. I can buy two. I get the 10 mil and the 45. And shit, let's go 4,500 and I'll buy all three. I'll have one of each. Although I only got two hands. Maybe just two 10 mils. Boondock Saints style. Double 10s. That'd be sweet. 3,000 high fives. I guess I can do that. You would get so tired. And you're so short, you couldn't even reach my hand if I was giving you a high five. So you couldn't even do it. You'd hit me in the nipple. Love you, Mike. Oh, you're good, Matt. It's all good, man. People got stuff to do rather than listen to me. So who's ready for some giveaways, guys? We're going to keep this one a little shorter today. My mouth still hurts. I got pizza waiting in the other room. I need to eat some. And I'm just going to... Oh, I'm just going to keep fondling my Kimber. The Black Ice Rapide. This thing is sweet. Make sure you guys watch for the video. Check out my YouTube video on this too, guys. I think you'll like it. Kimber even commented on my YouTube video. Because I'm all, like literally one of the only ones that's had one of these in their hands so far. Which is pretty cool. And they liked my bench review of this thing. So they're going to love my... My shooting review of it, I know they will because it's going to be awesome as long as it functions. If it has problems, it's going to be shitty. So, all right, who's ready for some giveaways? The first one is the Kimber. It's just a picture of it. I'll give you a picture of it from my cell phone. I'll text it to you. My mouth's feeling all right. It still hurts. It sucks. It still hurts. I'm actually about to call the dentist tomorrow maybe and figure out why. It still hurts so bad because it shouldn't, I don't feel. That gun would look like an AR in Mike's hands. It's funny. It's funny because he's short. I can't stop playing with this thing, guys. The slide's just so easy to move. Oh, I might need a minute. All right. So who's ready for some giveaways? Let's light this screen up with likes and hearts, some comments. We got a couple things to give away today. You guys want to see what we're giving away? Oh, if I ever get sad, talked about that whole depression thing earlier. Just stroke my black ice rapide. I'll feel okay. Everything will be all right. All right. Put my gun down. I'm gonna put it back in its like nice soft case here. Bye bye, Kimber. Love you. All right. So what should we give away first? So today. Actually, here, we'll show you this one first so it makes sense. We got some ammo. This is, you can't get this right now. You guys know that, so this is worth a lot of money. This is some Critical Defense Light from Hornady. it's 100 grain FTX, the Critical Defense Light, and it's got pink tips. I don't know if you can see that, but it's like their breast cancer awareness stuff or whatever. Shoots really well. It's only 100 grain, so it's a lighter round. But it's awesome stuff. It's pretty much their critical duty, just a little bit lighter. So it's good stuff. Make sure that you use it in good health. This is a 20 round box. And then I have a Hornady hat that I'm going to give away because I'm giving away Hornady ammo. So this is a says Hornady on the back. Super nice hat. I put it on earlier and I was like, man, this hat actually fits me pretty well. Like, I kind of don't want to give it away, but I'm going to give it away to you guys. And then we have, of course, some magazines because we always give magazines away on this show because Athlon Outdoors is awesome and I write for them. So why not give them some of their stuff away? So today we're going to give away New Pioneer magazine. This is a super cool, like, kind of a prepper magazine, gardening. It's got all this stuff that you can't do in Michigan right now. It's got all that kind of stuff in it. Butterfly, how to do butterfly houses. Stuff about horses, donkeys, and the mule marketeers. I don't know. Like, there's some pretty cool articles in here, guys. It's a, I started reading this magazine and I was like, man, I actually like this stuff. Like, I wasn't into that at all. We got that one, and then we got one that's perfect for all this stuff going on, Survivor's Edge. This magazine was, like, built for COVID-19, and obviously it says it right there on the top. So this is the new Survivor's Edge. I don't do much writing for these two particular titles, so I don't have articles in these ones, but there's some really good stuff in here. And actually, Will Dabbs is a doctor. He's actually a doctor, and he writes for us as well. Which is pretty cool because he's got a couple articles in here. So, it was 9 mil, not 40 cal. 9 mil Hornady. What did I do with it? There it is. 9 mil. 100 grain, critical duty light. A critical defense light, I'm sorry, from Hornady. So we're going to give away New Pioneer first. All right. So we're going to do a number. Turn this over here. It's for New Pioneer Magazine. Shipped right to your house. Number 1 through 100. 1 through 100. So when you guys see start guessing. Start guessing, guys, number 1 through 100. First person to get it gets the magazine. First person that I see gets the magazine. Because trust me, sometimes I don't see all the comments. Sometimes they don't show up at all. That's the problem. So 1 through 100, guys, for New Pioneer Magazine. New Pioneer is phenomenal. It is. It's a sweet magazine. For you. I don't know what that means, but it's not the right number. 1 through 100, guys. Keep guessing. I'm looking at my phone and the computer screen, so hopefully, no matter what, I will see the number when you guess it. Ian just joined us. What's up, Ian? Of course, you guessed 69 right off the bat. 1 through 100, guys, for New Pioneer Magazine. Here goes Tom Ingram with his damn hockey numbers. Oh, we have a winner. Stop guessing. Stop guessing. All right. So the winner. The winner just joined us. I just said his name. Is Ian for New Pioneer Magazine. Ian Marshbank, good job, buddy. So you win New Pioneer. I know you live local, but you work out of state. So if you're in the area, we'll meet up or whatever. I'll get you this magazine rather than shipping it. But if you need me to ship it somewhere, just let me know. Not a problem. So congratulations on that. Everybody stop guessing. Let's clear the board here. And then when you see the word start again, we're doing numbers 1 through 100. Jeff said I need an assistant to help me with the giveaways. It would be nice. Are you volunteering next week? All right. In the ammo. yeah, hopefully I'll have that soon. All right, so this is for Survivor's Edge, guys. Survivor's Edge. Lost my screen. There we go. This is the new issue of Survivor's Edge. Perfect for everything going on right now in the crazy-ass country. 1 through 100. When you guys see the word start, you can start guessing. Numbers 1 through 100. This is for Survivor's Edge. Oh, thank you, Chris, for a nice shirt. Thank you for reminding me, buddy. I forgot to mention that. I'll talk about that in a second. 1 through 100. This is for Survivor's Edge. 88 miles an hour. Numbers 1 through 100. Tell Moe to get off her butt and help. She is helping. She's keeping a dog and a child occupied. 1 through 100 for Survivor's Edge magazine, guys. Come on, 1 through 100. I haven't seen it yet. Keep guessing. 1 through 100 for Survivor's Edge magazine. So, Jeff, were you volunteering to come help next week or what? $1 million. Nope. Keep going, guys. 1 through 100. Nobody, come on. One through 100. Some people getting close. I'll give you that hint. All right. Let's drop it down. 1 through 50. 1 through 50 now. We'll get through these. We got two more still. 1 through 50. One through 50, guys. For Survivor's Edge magazine. Keep guessing. 1 through 50. People are getting close. That's all I can say. Doesn't mean anything for you guys because you don't know what numbers I'm seeing, but... One through 50. Apparently, I picked the hardest number ever. 1 through 50. Chris, do you want me to give a shirt away? If you want me to give a shirt away, Chris, I'll give one away today. A new shirt. All right, 1 through 30. We're going 1 through 30. I've cut it down. You got 30 numbers to pick from now. All right, we'll give one away. I need a helper, apparently. Why do I need a helper so bad? I'm watching. Oh, we have a winner, finally. Stop guessing. We have a winner. That one took a long time. All right, so the winner of Survivor's Edge magazine is Tina. Tina SBG. Tina Grossman. Got Survivor's Edge. Congratulations. It's a pretty cool issue of Survivor's Edge, actually. It's got some pretty cool articles in it. And a whole thing on how to make your own face masks that actually work and stuff like that. So, pretty cool. Congratulations, Tina, on Survivor's Edge. I don't know where Dennis is, Joe. I talked to him briefly earlier on text, and he just said that he couldn't make it. So, I think he's just staying away because of all this crap, which is fine. He's been taking care of his father-in-law a little bit, helping out up there, so he probably just doesn't want to be exposed to anything more than he needs to be, which is fine. No big deal. I'm sure he'll be back once all this crap is done. All right, so while we're giving that away, guys, Chris from Freedom Fatigues, which you guys know this company pretty well, if you watch this, because we give a lot of their stuff away. This shirt I'm wearing, the Liberty or Death shirt, is the newest design. I don't even think it's on their website yet. Maybe it is. I haven't taken pictures of it yet, but Chris said, let's give the Liberty or Death shirt away. So we're going to give a Liberty or Death shirt away to one of you guys from, look at that. I already had it up there. Freedom Fatigues. I had that on the screen still from last time, so that's cool. Jeff said, I'm literally sitting next to her, and I'm a good 20 seconds behind her video. Yeah, it's ridiculous. Like, my video is different when Dennis is sitting next to me than his. The computer's different than the video, than the phones. Moe's phone is behind mine. It's insane. My program to Facebook is at least 10 second delay by itself, no matter what. And then the Facebook thing is crazy. I can't watch myself on Facebook. I have the Facebook screen covered with the program I use to get all these graphics up here. And I can see the comments on the side. But if I watch myself on Facebook, it's ridiculously delayed, and I don't know if I'm talking or if I'm moving or what. It's super awkward. So yeah, you guys gotta light this screen up. I need more likes. Yes, he does make fat guy sizes up to 3X. So he has a shirt that will fit you, Jeff. I need likes and hearts. This whole screen for Freedom Fatigues. You guys, I think this means that we're going to hold off on the hat tonight, maybe. I don't know. We'll see. You guys want the hat still? There it is. There's the website. Freedomfatigues.com. It's up on your screen now. Man, you guys lit this up. Joe McAllister said, Christopher Richards, did you get my email? So he's had issues with his email. So, Chris, make sure you get a hold of Joe for something. I'm going to wash it. No, I'm not washing it. This is my shirt. You guys get another one from Freedom Fatigues. So, if you win the shirt, you got to send me your address and all that good stuff. And Freedom Fatigues will get you a package out. And you'll have your very own Liberty or Death shirt, which this is one of my favorite. He posted it this morning to me. It's better to die on your feet than live on your knees. And it's perfect for what we did yesterday. So I was like, I need that shirt. So he actually creepered it up. He like Joe Biden'd it today. And he just showed up on my porch. Like knocked on the window, and I was standing in front of the window on the front. And I just picked up my phone and saw that I missed a call from him, and then he just was there. He was all creepy about it. But he had a shirt, so I was happy. So it worked out good. All right, so let's give away the shirt next. So the shirt got a number written down. Again, he has sizes from small all the way up to 3X. So it'll be in your size, and he will ship it right to your house, and you will have a badass Freedom Fatigue shirt. So when you see start, numbers 1 through 100, and you guys can start guessing for the Liberty or Death brand new shirt from Freedom Fatigues. I don't know if it's even on the website. Chris, is it on the website yet? Start guessing 1 through 100, guys. This is for the Liberty or Death shirt from Freedom Fatigues. The same one I'm wearing, but not this exact shirt. You get a new one. This one smells like me. I don't know. Some people might like that, but I could rub Kimber all over it. Now you probably want this shirt, don't you? Oh, yeah. Just can't stop. Number 1 through 100. It's not 33, Jeff. And no, it's not my number. 7 isn't going to work. It's never going to be 33 or 7. Just know that right now. No, oh, wait. Did I miss it? Nope. I thought I saw it, but I didn't. 1 through 100. Keep guessing, guys. Numbers 1 through 100 for the Freedom Fatigues Liberty or Death brand new shirt that they just released. This thing is awesome. This is my new favorite shirt. I love it. I love the design on it. I love that it's pretty subtle. It's really showing up well in this light, but it's not that bright. Like, this ink is not really that much different than the color of the shirt, so it's kind of like a ghost image. It's kind of cool. I like it. Keep guessing. 1 through 100, guys. Oh, we have a winner. Stop guessing. We got a winner. All right, we have a winner, guys. Everybody stop guessing. The winner of the Liberty or Death shirt from Freedom Fatigues, that is right up on the top of the screen here. Make sure you check out their website, freedomfatigues.com. All American made. Awesome, awesome stuff. It's pretty much the only clothes I wear anymore. The winner is Norman Watch Pocket. So congratulations, Norman. I don't think you've won yet. You watch quite often, and I don't think you've won anything. So, Norman, make sure you private message me your address and the size of the shirt that you need, and I will get that over to Chris from Freedom Fatigues, and they will get that shipped out to you probably this week. So congratulations, Norm. Got yourself a new shirt, man, from Freedom Fatigues. Awesome shirt. It's got the flag on the shoulder there. That's an awesome shirt. I love this shirt. So now that we gave that away, should we just hold off on the ammo? I don't know. What do you guys think? Should we give away some ammo? I've decided I'm combining if we give this away. I'm going to give you a hat and the ammo together. But maybe we'll just hold off till next week. I don't know. What do you guys think? What do you guys think here? Hold off? Why? Joe's guessing still. Show us the pink. That sounds bad. but I know what you're talking about. But yes, these are pink rounds. So you guys want to win these? This will be the last giveaway. We'll give away the hat and the ammo together. But he is serious. They do have a pink. It's really hard to see. It's a pink tip in there, though. That little polymer tip is pink on these. 20 rounds of amazingness. 9 mil, Matt, 9 mil. Joe, Chris just saw your email. Apparently he's got you. So, all right. I guess you guys don't want to get any ammo because nobody has given me any likes. Nobody said yes. They want this other giveaway. Nothing. EJ said do it. That's it, though. Just one? One person wants this? There we go. Now we got some hearts and stuff on the screen. All right. We got some hearts and some comments. So I guess we'll give away. Joe wants 300 blackout. What? 9 mil is not good enough for you to win for free? Get out of here. 45. I'm giving 9 mil away because I showed you a 9 mil. Everything I do correlates somehow. That's why the hat comes into play. Hornady hat, Hornady ammo. Got it. So we're giving away 9 mil. You guys can tell me what rounds you want all day long. But I'm giving away 20 rounds of critical defense light 9 mil and the Hornady hat. This is going to go together. You're going to get it with the ammo in the hat. That's what I've decided. So we're giving that away. Number 1 through 100. And before we start, I want to remind you guys at the bottom of the screen here, if you guys could possibly donate a few bucks to my PayPal or my Venmo, it pays for the shipping of all this stuff and makes it possible to give this stuff away. Like the Hornady, this is out of my pocket. I bought this ammo. This is out of my ammo collection. The Hornady hat I luckily got for free, but it still costs a lot of money to ship ammo and hats. And magazines cost like $6 a piece to ship. Like, it's not cheap. So when you're not shipping huge quantities. So if you guys can donate a couple bucks, I'd greatly, greatly appreciate it. And that just goes to the giveaways. If I end up getting extra money, like I said, I don't make anything on these things. So that extra money is just going to make better, bigger, and better prizes. So if you guys can go donate, that would be awesome. And we're going to give away the Hornady Critical Defense Light. Keep messing that up. 100 grain, 20 rounds of 9 mil, and the hat comes with it. All right, when you see start, you're guessing 1 through 100. I guess I should write down a number, though. Trying to think of a good one. Okay, I got the number. When you see start, I'm guessing 1 through 100 for the ammo and the hat. EDC and the hat. It's not a hard explanation, Norm, to explain to her why you need 9 mil. Because you have 9 mil ammo if you win it. It's really easy. 20 rounds of Hornady Critical Defense Light 100 grain 9mm and a Hornady hat for you guys. This is the last giveaway, and then we're getting out of here until next week. If you guys have any ideas that you want to hear about or like things to talk about on this show, I don't ever script anything. I don't write anything down. I just come up with ideas to talk about. And like the thing on the side of the screen over here is literally just for me to look at to remind myself to kind of keep on pace and keep going. So if you guys have ideas, message me with them. Comment on this video. Comment on the YouTube videos. Whatever you want to do. And let me know what you guys want to see or talk about. And I'm always open for new stuff. So, and I don't care about what you want me to give away. I'm not giving the Kimber away. No, not happening. God, I love this gun, though. Let's keep playing with it. 1 through 100, guys, for the ammo and the hat. And not the Kimber. It's kind of crazy. My phone and my computer are literally synced right now, which never happens, which is pretty cool. 1 through 100. Keep guessing. Numbers 1 through 100, guys. The last giveaway of the day. Oh, we have a winner. Stop guessing. We have a winner. All right. Stop guessing, guys. The winner of the Hornady hat and the 9mm is Jeff Grossman. Nice job. So Jeff Grossman, you got the ammo and the hat. Congratulations. And what did your wife won? Survivor's Edge. So the household cleaned up today. This is what's going home with you guys today. So I think I'll see you tomorrow, hopefully. So I will be able to give that to you. So congratulations, everybody that won. Ian, I will see you when I have some stuff for you that I'm going to have hopefully this, the end of this week or tomorrow, or the weekend. So I'll see you and I'll get you that. Norman, make sure you message me with your, address and the size that you need of the Freedom Fatigues Liberty or Death shirt. Awesome new shirt from Freedom Fatigues. Make sure you guys check out freedomfatigues.com. It's right there. It is freedomfatigues.com right there. Make sure you guys check them out. Awesome stuff. American made. Excellent, excellent clothing and apparel. And they got a bunch of other stuff. He's got beard care stuff on his website now. He's got bar glasses and barware. He's got all kinds of cool stuff on there, so make sure you guys check them out. They donate a lot for us on this channel to give away to you guys. So, and again, shipping costs a lot of money. If you guys can donate to the PayPal or the Venmo, a couple bucks would be awesome. Frank said, what was the number? I don't give out the numbers ever because it just causes fights and problems. I write them down and I don't change them, and you guys can see, boop, that's the numbers. That's how fast you get to see it. Cause it seriously just causes a bunch of issues. Cause then everybody's like, oh, I guess that number. I guess that number. Facebook sucks. And it's just kind of the luck of the draw, unfortunately. But it is what it is. So, thank you guys for watching. Make sure you guys follow me on Instagram. If you have one, Pew Pew Nation, super easy to remember. Follow my or subscribe to my YouTube channel. Check out the video on the Kimber that I posted a couple days ago. This is the Black Ice Rapide. It's one of the only bench reviews out there because I'm one of the only ones that has this gun in their hands right now. Check out all that good stuff. Invite all your friends to join the Right to Bear Arms page. And stay safe, stay healthy, guys. We will see you next week, 7 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Thanks for watching, guys.